So for the previous sessions, we see about the theories of light, isn't it? Isn't it? So what are the theories of light we see in previous sessions? We see the four theories, isn't it? Corpuscular theory, wave theory, electromagnetic theory, and the quantum theory. So corpuscular theory was proposed by Newton. According to the Newton, the light is a tiny massless, perfectly elastic particles are called as corpuscles, isn't it? And we explain the phenomena, isn't it? And he explained that whenever the corpuscles touch the retina of eye, the visions will be produced. And different size of a corpuscles, let's say the different colors of a light. And also he explained that. What's the point? He explained that. He explained the phenomena of reflections and refraction. The next one is the wave theory. So Christian Huygens was the one who explained the wave theory. According to the Huygens, the light is a form of, what is that? The light is a disturbance of a source which is in the form of longitudinal mechanical wave propagated in a either medium. They successfully explain the phenomena of reflection, refractions, interference and diffractions. And third one is, what's the third one now? What's that one? Electromagnetic wave theory, isn't it? So the Maxwell was the one who proposed the electromagnetic theory. According to the Maxwell, the light is a transverse wave in nature, or light is electromagnetic wave or transverse wave in nature, and it doesn't require any medium for the propagations. And they successfully explain the phenomena of reflection, refractions, interference, diffraction, and also the polarizations. And the fourth one, what we see that the quantum theory is that Albert Einstein, and based on the view of Max Planck, he was the one who proposed that the quantum theory is that. So according to that, the light, what is that? Whenever the light will be interact with the matter as photons to eject electrons. So according to the Einstein, the light is a form of photon. Each photon, light is a packet of energy called photon. Each packet of energy is equal to h into mu, and h represents the Planck's constant, and mu represents the frequency of wave, isn't it? Then we see that whenever the light will be propagated, they treat it as a wave. Whenever the light will be interact with the matter, they behave as a. Whenever the light will be interact with the matter, they behave as a. Matters, okay, clear. Then last one is that we see the wave front, isn't it? So guys, what is wave front? The wave front is the locus of point, isn't it? What is that? The wave front is the locus of point which having same state of the same phase of vibration, isn't it? The wave front is the locus of point in which having same state of the same phase of vibrations, in which the wave front is depends upon the size and shape of a source. What is that? It depends upon the shape of a source and also a distance of a source. Okay, if the source will be point source at finite distance, means they form a spherical wave front. If it is a line source, means at a finite distance, means they form a plane wave front. And if a source is at infinite distance, means they form a plane wave front, isn't it? And if it is a line source, means what type of wave front will be formed? Cylindrical wave front will be formed. Okay, what type of wave front will be formed? The cylindrical wave front will be formed. Okay, so for this class we are going to see about the Huygens principle and the law of reflections using Huygens principle. Okay, clear. So what is Huygens principle means? Huygens principle is the geometrical construction. What is that? The Huygens principle is the geometrical construction which gives the size and shape of a wave front. What is that? Which gives the size and the shape of wave front. Which gives the size and shape of a wave front. Okay, at an instrument of any type. According to the Huygens principle, what is that? According to the Huygens principle, each point on the wavefront, what is that? Each point on the wavefront, they behave as a source of a secondary wavelet. They are spreading out in all directions with the speed of wave. This is called as a secondary wavelet. So the envelope, what is that? The secondary wavelet, what is that? This envelope to the all wavelet. What is that? This envelope to the all wavelet, which gives the size and shape of a new wavefront at that time. Okay, which gives the, what is that? The envelope to the wavefront, which gives the size and shape of a new wavefront. Okay, clear. So guys, what is Huygens principle? Each point on the wavefront, they act as a, what is that? Every point on each point on the wavefront, they act as a source of a secondary wavelet. They are spreading out in all directions with the speed of wave. They are called as a secondary wavelet. So the envelope to this wavelet, what is that? The envelope to the wavelet, they act as the source of. Okay, the envelope to the wavelet, they gives the size and shape of a new wavefront. the size and shape of a new wavefront. Okay, so here we are going to see the propagation of a spherical and a plane wavefront. I'll be explained by using Huygens principle. Okay, what is that? The propagation of a spherical and wavefront will be explained by using Huygens principle. Okay, guys, understand? So what's the purpose here on Huygens principle? Huygens principle is the geometrical construction which gives the size and shape of a wavefront. Which gives the size and shape of a wavefront. Okay. So according to the Huygens principle, each point on the wavefront, what is that? Each point on the wavefront, they act as the source of a secondary wavelet. They are spreading out in all directions with the speed of wave. They are called as a secondary wavelet. So the envelope to the wavelet which gives the size and shape of a new wavefront at the instant of time. Okay, let us consider. Here we are going to find the propagation of a spherical wavefront and the plane wavefront by construction using Huygens principle. Okay, so here it is a point source. They are producing a spherical wavefront. They are producing a spherical wavefront. Okay, for a time t is equal to 0. The wavefront is taken as a and b. A, b be the new wavefront. For a time t is equal to 0, the wavefront is considered as a b. Here we know that the light will be, the waves will be spreading out in all directions with the speed of light, isn't it? So we make a 3 point p, q, r. So each point on the wavefront, they act as the source of a secondary wavelet, isn't it? So here we make a point and start draw a circle. What is that? Draw a circle with the radius of CT. We are going to draw a circle with the radius of CT. So what's the circle radius of? Having draw a circle with the radius of CT. Okay. Clear? So the envelope to the wavefront, what is that? The envelope to the wavefront. What's the envelope of? A dash, B dash. Okay? The envelope to the wavefront. Okay? The envelope to the wavelet which gives the size and shape of another wavefront, A dash, B dash. Which gives the new wavefront, A dash, B dash. Okay? Here, if the source is at the finite distance, or the point source is at finite distance, means what type of wavefront will be formed? Spherical wavefront will be formed. If it is at the finite, if it is at infinite distance, means what is that? If a source is at infinite distance, means what type of wavefront will be formed? The plane wavefront will be formed. What type of wavefront will be formed? The plane wavefront will be formed. So if it is a plane wavefront, A, B, okay. If it is a new wavefront A, B for a time t is equal to 0. For a time t is equal to 0. So we make a 3 point. 1, 2, 3. P, Q, R. Okay. So we are going to draw a circle with the radius of, what is that? We are going to draw a circle with the radius of CT. 1, 2, 3. Okay. So the envelope to the wavelet. What is that? The envelope, the tangent to the envelope. What is that? The tangent to the envelope which gives the new wavefront A dash, B dash. The tangent to the envelope which gives the new wavefront A dash, B dash. Okay, clear? There is the one shortcoming in the above construction of a Huygens principle. Because here the Huygens principle doesn't explain the absence of a backward wave. Here only we see the forward propagation, isn't it? It doesn't explain the backward wave. Okay. But according to the electromagnetic wave, the backward wave, what is that? The backward wave is ruled out inherently. Okay. According to the electromagnetic wave, the backward wave will be ruled out inherently. So the Huygens principle is one of a good diagrammatic construction. What is that? The Huygens principle is the one, is a good diagrammatic construction which gives the size and shape of a wavefront, which gives the size and shape of a wavefront, which gives the size and shape of a wavefront. Clear? Clear? Understand? It's one of the important 2 mark questions. State Huygens principle. Okay? So guys, what is Huygens principle? Huygens principle is the geometrical construction which gives the size and shape of a wavefront, which gives the size and shape of a wavefront. According to the Huygens principle, each point on the wavefront, according to the Huygens principle, each point on the wavefront, they act as the source of secondary wavelet. Okay, they spreading out in all direction with the speed of wave. They spreading out in all direction with the speed of wave. They are called as a secondary wavelet. They are called as a secondary wavelet. So the envelope to the wavelet, which gives the shape of a, or size and shape of a new wavefront. Okay, so for a time t is equal to 0, the wavefront will be AB. Or we are going to see the spherical and geometric spherical and plane wavefront for the construct. The propagation of the spherical wavefront, plane wavefront by using Huygens principle. Here we will take a new wavefront AB. AB. It's a spherical wavefront, it's a plane wavefront. Okay. For a time t is equal to 0. So we make a 3 point. P, Q, R. Here also P, Q, R. Okay. So we draw a circle with the radius of CT, because distance, what's the formula for? Because they are traveling with the speed of light, isn't it? So distance is equal to, this velocity is equal to distance by time. So distance is equal to CG. So we draw a three circle. The tangent to the circle is the forward envelope of new wavefront A dash B dash. Here also, the forward to the tangent to the envelope of a new wavelet, which give R the wavelet, which gives the size and shape of a new wavefront A dash B dash. There is only one shortcoming in the Huygens principle, that doesn't explain the backward propagation of waves. But according to the electromagnetic theory, the backward release or backward propagation of wave will be ruled out inherently. So the Huygens principle is the good diagrammatic explanation for the construction for the size and shape of a wavefront. Okay, in case if a source is at a finite distance, means they produce the spherical wavefront, or if a source is a point source, or if it is a point source at a finite distance, means they produce a spherical wavefront, and if it is the source is at an infinite distance, means they're producing a plane wavefront. They produce the plane wavefront. Clear? The next one is the law of reflections using Huygens principle. So before we go for the law of reflections, guys, what is the law of reflections? The incident ray, the reflected ray, normal at the point of incidence, coplanar, or they lie on a same plane. They lie on a same plane. Then, second one. What's the second one? The angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Right? So here we are going to see the law of reflections using Huygens principle. Okay, clear? So let us consider a parallel ray of light fall on a reflecting surface XY. Okay, let us consider a parallel ray of light. Okay, consider a parallel beam of light fall on a reflecting surface. So here, let us consider a parallel beam of light will be R. Let us consider a parallel beam of light fall on a reflecting surface. So, clear? L, M be the incident rays. L, M be the incident rays. Let's go. L dash, M dash be the reflected ray. Okay, and L dash, M dash be the reflected ray. In which A, B be the, what is that? A, B be the incident wavefront. Then reflect a wavefront. A dash B dash be the reflector wavefront. Okay, clear? Clear. So guys, here what are the point is here? Let us consider a parallel beam of light ray fall on a reflecting surface XY in which L and M be the incident ray, L dash M dash be the reflected ray, L dash M dash be the reflected ray. Here AB be the incident wavefront and A dash B dash be the reflected wavefront. Okay, clear. So here you have to remember only one this point. Okay, by the time of the wavefront touch the reflecting surface at a point A, by the time of what is that? By the time of the wavefront touch the point of A, the light B is yet to travel a distance of B dash. The light ray B is yet to travel a distance of B to B dash. When it is reached, what is that? When this light ray touch the point of B dash, the light will be reflected and to reach the point of A dash. The light will be reflected to reach the point of A dash. Okay, so solunga the wavefront A vandu inda point the wavefront point A touch pannumbodhu B is yet to travel a distance of B B dash. The B is yet to travel a distance of B B dash. When this light ray touch the point of B dash, in the light ray in the B dash touch pannumbodhu A unakku enna irukku wavefront reflect a inga reach a irukum A dash la reach a irukum. The wavefront will be reflected and touch the point of A dash. Clear? Clear. Let's go. N and N dash be the normal. Okay, N and N dash be the normal at the point of incidence. Okay, N and N dash be the normal at the point of incidence. Here, both the reflections will be happen in the same medium, isn't it? So the light will be travel in the same speed. The light will be travel in the same speed. So the distance B B dash is equal to A A dash. The distance B B dash and A A dash are equal. The distance B B dash and A A dash are equal. Clear? Clear? So guys, say the point. What are the point? We say that X Y be the reflecting surface. X Y be the reflecting surface in which L M be the incident ray. L M be the incident ray. Next one. L dash M dash be the refractor ray. L dash M dash be the refractor ray in which A B be the incident wavefront. A B be the incident wavefront. A dash B dash be the reflector wavefront. A dash B dash be the reflector wavefront. Then N and N dash be the normal at the point of incidence. What is that? N and N dash be the normal at the point of what is that? Normals at the point of incidence. Okay, so make angle of incidence I R. Clear? Clear. And that is the only one point you have to remember. By the time of the wavefront touch the point of A, B is said to travel a distance of B B dash. When it is touch the point of B dash, the A will be reflected and reach the point of A dash. And also the both reflections will be happen in the same medium. What is that? Both the reflections will be happen in the same medium. The light or the speed of light will be in same will be a the speed of light will be same. Okay. So the distance of B B dash and A dash are equal. Okay. So guys, so write the first point. What's the first point? The incident ray, reflector ray, normal at the point of incidence. What is that? Normal at the point of incidence are coplanar. Normal at the point of incidence are coplanar. Okay, is that? Is that? Ella oru point thane incident ray, the reflect at the normal at the point of incidence or coplanar. They lie on a same plane. They lie on a same plane. Okay. Then second, angle of incidence. So guys, here what's the angle of incidence are there? The angle of incidence is equal to N A L. Isn't it? The angle of incidence is equal to N A L, which is equal to here. What's the total angle? 90 degrees, isn't it? In which the 90 degree minus N A B. The 90 degree minus N A B. The 90 degree minus N A B. Okay. Clear? The 90 degree minus N A B, right? 90 degree minus angle of N A B, which is equal to B A B dash, which is equal to the angle of B A B dash. Okay, clear? So guys, what is the angle of incidence of? The angle of incidence is equal to I is equal to N A L is equal to the total angle 90 degree minus N A B, which is equal to B A B dash, which is equal to B A B dash. Clear? Clear. The next one. The angle of reflections. What is that? The angle of reflection. So here what is the angle of reflections of N dash B dash M dash? Okay, right? R is equal to N dash B dash M dash. Okay, which is equal to 90 degree minus the angle N dash B dash A dash. What do you get up? N dash B dash A dash, which is equal to the angle of refractions of A dash B dash A, which is equal to the angle of refractions A dash B dash A. Clear? Clear. So you understand the two angles. So what is the angle of refractions of, right? N dash B dash M dash is equal to 90 degree minus N dash B dash A dash, which is equal to A dash B dash A. Okay, clear. So from this we make the two triangles. The triangle, what is that? The triangle, what are the triangle we take as that? From the two rectangle triangles. The first triangle, the triangle A B B dash. And the second triangle, the triangle B dash A dash A. So we are assuming a two triangle. What are the triangle? The triangle A B B dash and the second triangle B dash A dash A, which means now in the angle or the B U in the A dash angle or we take a two triangles. Okay, in which we take a triangle, the angle of B is equal to the angle of A because both angles are 90 degree. And in which we know that the distance B B dash is equal to A B dash. Is that B B dash is equal to A A dash? And one more thing, the common for the both triangle A B dash will be common for both triangles. Then A B dash will be, what is that? The A B dash should be common for both triangle. So by the triangles are concurrent, by concurrency rule, what is that? The two triangles are, because these two triangles are concurrent, so by the concurrency rule, what do you get? The angle of B A B dash is equal to the angle of A dash B dash A. So what is the angle B A B dash? I. What is the angle A B dash A? R. So I is equal to R. So the law of refractions will be valid. So guys, here you take a, what is the angle? In the angle we are assuming two triangles. First triangle, the triangle A B B dash. The second one B dash A dash A. So the angle B of angle A dash will be common. So one more thing, the distance DB dash is equal to AA dash are equal. Both the triangle they having of common area, common side AB dash. Both the triangle they having of common side AB dash. So the both the triangles are concurrent. By the rule of concurrency, the side BA B dash is equal to A dash B dash is into A. So we can substitute the means secant value of I is equal to R. So the law of refractions will be valid. Clear? So guys, here what's the point is here that the incident ray, the reflected ray, normal at the point of incidence of coplanar. Then we find the angle of incidence. I is equal to NAL 90 degree minus NAB, which is equal to VA B dash. And law of refraction R is equal to N dash B dash, N dash is equal to 90 degree minus N dash B dash A dash, which is equal to A dash B dash A. Then we take two triangle, the angles are common, so the distance will be equal, so the one having common side, so the triangles are concurrent. By the rule of concurrency, I is equal to R. So the statics, by using the Huygens principle, we find the law, or we prove the law of refractions. Clear? So for this class, we learned one important 2-mark questions, along with that, one important 5-mark questions we learned. So I hope you guys understand, and please prepare for the exam, okay? Thank you guys.